So here we have Daisy, and this is going to be part of Daisy's Go Home video. First, we're going to start off with her sits and downs. So I'm going to get Daisy from over here. Really distract him. Sit. Good girl. It's good to work in this distracting environment, though. We're building her confidence. Sit. Good girl. We're also making the words seem easier for her in the long run to work in the distracting environment. Daisy. Down. Good girl. Daisy, sit. Daisy, down. Good. Good girl. Daisy, come. Good. Sit. Down. Good. Good girl. Sit. Like you're lifting your nose to the ceiling. Good girl. Down. Referencing to the floor. Good girl. Oops, dropped your treat. Right there. Good girl. Now we're going to do her leash walking. I'm going to keep her to my left side, telling her this way. This way. Good girl. This way. On her easy and waiting for Slack and Elise to continue walking. Of course, she didn't go talk with her, which is perfectly fine. But I just don't want her to walk in front of me. I want to keep her next to me or behind me. This way. Good girl. This way. Good girl. Stays. So I'm going to tell her sit. Put up a handstand. So when she goes to lay down, she's going to lift her back up to that sit. Oh, she did it herself. Stay. Take her right back to the same exact spot. Put her back in the same positions, okay? And start over with that stay command. And the release word is okay. Good girl, good job. Do that again. Sit, stay. So now she's broken away. Pick her up, put her back in the same spot, same position. Stay. And take her back to the same spot, put her back in the same position. Stay.
Step out of sight.
Stay. So she breaks away, she's gonna scoop her up gently. Take her back to the same spot. Same position. Stay. Keep in mind Daisy has this down really pat, but for the purpose of this video, I don't want her to do perfect. I want it to be that she messes up so you can know how to work through it with her. Stay. video, we're going to do her kennel and weight. We're going to use this kennel right here. I'm going to get her attention.
Hi.
Yes. I'm going to tell her kennel. Show her gets me yummy. Throw her right in there for her. She's a little more focused on me and my hands than the treats. I know she just wants a crazy yes. Oh, hello. So our kennel, good girl. Waiting until her focus is on me and not eating. So I'm letting her finish up those treats and then I'll tell her wait. She goes to bar jaw, say ah, close her back in there and start over with that weight command. Wait. Okay, good girl. Good. Do that again. Take that treat. Toss it in the tower count. Good girl. Wait until her focus is on me not eating. Wait. Okay, good girl. So just like when Lucy came home, she came home with a soaker pad, so little Daisy here, she'll go home with that kennel, and you'll be able to utilize it in her kennel, just until she gets settled in. And then of course, as she gets a little older, you can add a dog bed, but always having something between them and the tray is really good for their joint and hip health. So I'm gonna tell her weight. Okay, good girl. Now these words, okay, good job. Yes, lots of praise. I'm gonna tell her kennel, oh, she didn't see. I'm not going number three. Good girl, all the way in there. Keeping it nice and positive. Good girl. We also use the weight command when walking through doorways or across the street. Helps set her up for good success with patience, good manners, as well as safety. So telling her weight. She goes for a dog, saying, uh-uh, closing her back in there. If she squeezes out, getting her right back in and starting over with that weight command. Wait. Okay. Yes, good job. Good girl. Okay. So a little distracted right now, which is really great because I want you to see how she does when she messes up and how to continue working on this and keeping it positive for Daisy. Wait. Okay. Good girl. Kim, good. Wait. Okay. Yeah, that's good. So another thing you can do when trying to crate her, because you don't always want to fill her up, especially if you just took her out to go potty and you want her to be on an empty tank, taking a crate safe toy or a long-term treat, you get her attention. Toss that toy in there, tie her kennel, go to girl. And just like you would with that treat, you want to make sure that her focus is on you and not chewing that toy when you want to tell her the weight command. Wait. Okay. Good girl. Kennel. Good. Using those positive mark words. Yes. Good. Good girl. Wait. Okay. Good girl. Good job. Sit. Good. Done. Keeping that kennel positive so she wants to go in there is really great. I'm going to close it out so maybe it's a little less of a distraction. Find her sit, stay, fly up in here.
Just turn the camera a bit.
Uh-huh. She's a really smart girl. Daisy, sit. Found a free piece of food and realized it was not a treat. Sit, down, stay. So when she breaks away, she's gonna take her and put her right back into that down. Nice and gentle. She thinks I'm picking her up. Put her right back into that down. Down. Stay. And this is just to demonstrate follow. So we're getting her back in the same spot, same position, sets her up for success down the road. She's a goofy girl. I'm gonna give her the release here in this moment. She's so fun. I love working with her. She's a really good girl. And I have no doubt she's going to fit in so nice in your home. Sit. Down. Down. Good. Stay. No treats at the beginning of this app. Instead, I want the treat to be the end goal. Put it back into that down. I want to try to do this as quick as possible, but keeping it positive. Stay. I'm going to pull those feet right out. Stay. And it's kind of good that she's messing up now. I want you to see how she is when she messes up and how to positively move forward and keep it positive and successful. Okay. Yes, good girl. Good. Sit. Down. Good. And another strong squeeze. Sit. Down. Sit. Let's see if she'll do it. Yes, good girl. Good job. All right, so this is Daisy doing her stays and her kennel and wait. Yes, good job.
Good girl. Yes, good. Please. Okay. Yes, good girl. Good job. Okay, let's do it again. Place. Good. Good girl. Okay, good girl, good girl. I'm gonna get her right on there. Place. I do give Daisy treats at the beginning of this command because I wanna keep it positive for her because she is very kinder-hearted and fragile. So I wanna make sure we keep things upbeat and light for her. So making sure I keep it positive and successful for her by using treats a little bit more than I probably would with some other puppies. That being said, when we're in a place that she's a little more comfortable, not outside where it's kind of somewhere we don't typically work, at least at this location we don't. So trying to make sure we keep it positive and using those treats. But if we were at the manor in our training room like we usually do this, then she would have no problem at all and I wouldn't need that extra encouragement, but that's okay. We want to go and do whatever's best and most comfortable for Daisy here. So so she breaks away. Just gonna gently guide her back onto that bed. Trying to do this one-handed and keeping it positive. So place. Just gently pick her up and guide her back on there. Of course, if you had two hands, you'd be able to do that a little easier. Okay. Yes, good girl. Good girl. Good. I'm gonna do it one more time. Yes, good. Place. The place command is far less structured than sit, stay, or down, stay. Sit, stay, or down, stay, she has to hold that position, whether it's the sit or the down. And when she breaks, she would have to go back to the same spot in the same position. Whereas with the place command, you just want to get her back on that corunda bed as quickly as positively as possible. So scooping her up, putting her right back on there, or guiding her back on if you had a leash is perfectly fine. Good girl. Good. For the purpose of this video, I want Daisy focused on me and the command and what I'm asking of her. But when she gets this done and down pat at your home, then you can start introducing a crate safe toy or long-term treat to keep her occupied and help the time pass faster. But she's doing really good with this. Turn my back to her. Let me just get the camera repositioned. Alright. Changing my body language to Daisy can sometimes be an introduction or possibly seen as an opening to break prematurely. But as you see, she's still holding. I'm just looking into the phone to see what she's doing. She's doing really great with this. Okay. Good girl. Good. I'm going to do it one more time. Good girl. This way. Place. Good. Good girl. Using those positive marker words, I'll even praise her throughout this. But she's doing really good. I timed her last week and we got it up to 25 minutes. So she can definitely hold this for quite some time. This is just more of a distracting environment and maybe one that she's not so used to working in for basic obedience, and that's fine. That's why we do these videos in different settings and why we change it up for them, so that we have to work through some distractions. And this video is not meant for Daisy to be perfect. It's meant to be utilized when she comes home to continue her training, keeping things positive, and keeping it very similar to what we're doing here. Good girl. Okay. Good girl. All right, you're going to tell her sit. Good. Down. Good girl. Good girl. Let's see if she'll do a sit. Sit. Good. Good girl. Daisy's awesome, and yeah, she's excited to come home to you. Good girl, good. Good job, good job, good.